Students, here afterwards we are going to solve problems in odd functions in between the interval minus pi comma pi. Let us solve a problem now, so that for f of x is equal to x into pi squared minus x squared divided by 12 is equal to sin x by 1 cube minus sin 2x by 2 cube plus sin 3x by 3 cube. In the interval minus pi is less than or equal to x, x is less than or equal to pi. Now the heading is given, problem is in the odd functions. Now we have to test whether the given function is an odd or an even function. Given that f of x equal to, given that f of x equal to x into pi squared minus x squared divided by 12, now let you find f of minus x. So it is equal to minus x into pi squared minus x, the whole squared is again x squared, already there is a minus, so it is pi squared minus x squared divided by 12. Now let you compare between f of x and f of minus x. F of x, we can find that f of x is equal to minus f of x. If f of x is equal to minus f of x, then the given function f of x is an odd function. Now we have decided that the given function is an odd function. Now step number 2. Once the function is decided as an odd function or an even function, so it is our responsibility to write the Fourier series expansion for the function. Now we have decided that the given function is an odd function, but now our responsibility is to write the Fourier series expansion for the odd function f of x in the interval minus pi comma pi. We already know that for an odd function, a0 is equal to 0 and an is equal to 0. Now f of x, the Fourier series expansion for f of x can be written as f of x is equal to sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity bn sin nx. This is a very important formula, you have to remember it. For odd function, f of x is equal to sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity bn sin x. There will not be any a0 term or an term. A0 is equal to 0 and an is equal to 0 for an odd function. F of x is equal to sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity bn sin nx. Now step number 3 is to find the value for the Fourier coefficient bn. Let us write the general formula that the function inside the integral is neither an odd function or an even function. So the formula for neither an even function nor an odd function for bn, it is equal to 1 by pi integral of minus pi to pi f of x into sin nx dx, and it is equal to 1 by pi minus pi integral of minus pi to plus pi x into pi squared minus x squared divided by 12 into sin nx dx. Now after substituting f of x here, let us test that the multiplication, whether the multiplication is an even function or an odd function. Now we have already tested f of x is an odd function. Now let us test sin nx is whether it is an odd function or even function. Now let us take phi of x is equal to sin nx. Now phi of minus x, now phi of minus x, phi of minus x is equal to sin of minus nx. Sin of minus nx can be written as minus sin nx, and comparing phi of x and phi of minus x, we understand that phi of x is equal to minus phi of minus x, hence sin x is an odd function. Now, we know that the odd function into an odd function, odd function into an odd function will give you an even function. In the previous slides, so we have given you that the odd into odd function will give you an even function. So now let us solve for bn based on the formula for an even function. So the formula for an even function is bn is equal to now bn can be written as 2 divided by pi integral of minus pi to plus pi. Now let you change the formula from neither nor to an even function. So for an even function, bn is equal to 2 divided by pi integral of minus pi to pi x into pi square minus x square divided by 12, when 12 is taken outside the integral. So 12 into sin x dx, when 12 is taken outside the integral, it will become 1 by 6 pi integral of minus pi to plus pi x into pi squared minus x squared into sin nx dx. Students, here you have to note one thing. When odd into odd is equal to even function, bn is equal to, it is not minus pi to pi integral of minus pi to pi, it is integral of 0 to pi. This you have to remember. Bn is equal to 2 divided by pi integral of 0 to pi x into pi squared minus x squared divided by 12 into sin nx dx. So which is equal to 12 is moved outside the integral, so it will become 1 by 6 pi integral 0 to pi x into pi squared minus x squared into sin nx dx. And this x can be multiplied inside the bracket, it will become x pi square minus x cube into sin nx dx. Now bn is equal to 1 divided by 6 pi integral of 0 to pi pi squared x minus x cube into sin nx dx. It is of the form integral of uv into dx model. So it is equal to Bernoulli's expansion, it is u into v1 minus u dash into v2 plus u double dash into v3 minus u triple dash into v4. Now let you use this formula to find out the integral for bn. So 1 divided by 6 pi is taken outside. First u into u is pi squared x minus x cube into v1. V1 is the integration of v. V is sin nx. Integration of sin is minus cos. So it is minus cos nx divided by the differentiation of nx is n. The next term is minus u dash into v2. U dash is differentiation of pi squared x minus x cube. Differentiation of pi squared x is pi squared. Minus x cube is 3x squared. So minus of pi squared minus 3x squared into v2. V2 is the integration of v1. V1 is minus cos nx divided by n. The integration of cos is sine. There is already a minus sign. So it is minus sine nx divided by differentiation of nx. Differentiation of nx is n. Already there is an n. N into n, it will become n squared. Plus u double dash into v3. U double dash is the differentiation of pi squared minus 3x squared. The differentiation of pi squared is 0. And the differentiation of minus 3x squared is minus 6x. So plus of minus 6x the into v3. V3 is minus sin x divided by n squared. So v3 is the integration of minus sin x sin nx divided by n squared. The integration of sin is minus cos. Already there is a minus. So minus of minus will become plus cos. So plus cos nx divided by the differentiation of nx is n. Already there is an n squared. N squared into n, it will become n cubed. The fourth term is minus u triple dash into v4. So minus v u triple dash is differentiation of minus 6x. Differentiation of minus 6x is minus 6. V4 is the integration of cos nx by n cube. Integration of cos is sine. So it is sine nx divided by the differentiation of nx is n. Already there is an n cube. So it is n cube into n, n power 4. The limits are applied from 0 to pi. Now let you think of further sine term. If pi is the upper limit, the pi is applied, the sine term will become sine n pi. So sine n pi is equal to 0. And when you apply the lower limit, 0, sine nx will become sine 0. Sine 0 is also equal to 0. So you need not bother about the sine nx term. And similarly, now you apply the upper limit to the first term. So pi squared x into pi, sorry, pi squared x will become pi squared into pi. So pi cube minus pi cube, it is becoming 0. When you apply the upper limit, so the first term is becoming 0. When you apply the lower limit also, pi squared into x is pi squared into 0, minus x cube is 0. So 0 into minus cos nx divided by n is equal to 0. So when you apply the upper limit and the lower limit, the first term is becoming 0. Now let you come to the third term, which is minus 6x into cos nx by n cube. Let you apply the upper limit. So it is minus 6 pi into cos n pi by n cube. When you apply the lower limit, minus 6 into 0 is equal to 0. So when you apply the lower limit, the term is becoming 0. Now we are having only one term by the application of limits, which is minus 6 pi into cos n pi divided by n cube. The minus 6 pi, 6 pi and 6 pi, they get cancelled each other. 6 pi and 6 pi, they get cancelled each other. Now it is equal to minus cos n pi divided by n cube, which is equal to minus of cos n pi is minus 1 power n divided by n cube. So minus 1 into minus 1 power n can be written as minus 1 power n plus 1 divided by n cube. So now we have found out a value for bn, which is equal to minus 1 power n plus 1 divided by n cube. The step number 4 is to write the Fourier series expansion. Step number 4 is to write the Fourier series expansion for f of x. Now f of x sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity bn sin nx. Now let you substitute the value for bn, which is equal to sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity. Bn is minus 1 power n plus 1 divided by n cube into sin x. So this is the Fourier series expansion. Now let you substitute the value from n is equal to 1 to infinity. So when you Now let you substitute n is equal to 1. When n is equal to 1, minus 1 to the power n plus 1, n plus 1 will become 2. Minus 1 to the power 2 is 1. In sin x, when n is equal to 1, it will become sin nx. N is equal to 1, it will become sin x. So sin x divided by 1 cube. When n is equal to 2, 2 plus 1 will become 3. Minus 1 to the power 3 is minus 1. In sin nx, n is equal to 2, it will become sin 2x. In front of that, minus 1 to the power n plus 1 is minus 1. So minus of sin 2x divided by 2 cube it is. When n is equal to 3, 3 plus 1 is equal to 4. And minus 1 to the power 4 is plus 1. So plus 1 into sin nx is sin 3x divided by 3 cube, and this is the required deduction.